Hello everybody. Today I'd like to show a few tips about modifying a blog posted on wordpress.com. So you perhaps already know that if you go on this site, you can create for free a blog, which is a very simple page like this with some text in it, and publish it on the internet. It will show probably when you first create the page, it will show like this with a couple of menus here. But perhaps at some point you will want to modify this blog. You will want to modify several elements. So for doing that, you will need to go through several hidden menus on this website. If you look to the left side, you think you'll have all the menus here, but this is far from true. If you need to modify several elements here, you'll need to go to some other places, which I'm going to show in this video. The very first thing I'm going to say is that you are better off working for editing, for modifying with a Chrome or a Microsoft Edge browser. This is because the browser I usually work with, my Mozilla Firefox, I had several problems with it. It didn't display properly the menus, the options. So I'm editing this on Chrome browser. So keep in mind this. And now let's see. What I'm going to show today, it's three main menus, menu pages. The first one, I'm going to show how to insert a picture inside the text. The second one, I'm going to show how to modify the text font and also modify here the title. And the third one, I'm going to show a completely new page with many, many settings. And among them, I will show a settings that will allow me to remove this gravatar, which is displayed by default by WordPress. First of all, if you look to the left here, you have this button settings. You may want to click on it and see what gives you as a settings. You have an option to modify the title of the site. You have some other options here. You may want to look through this. But this is not what I'm going to talk about it today. One thing I wanted to do is to introduce a picture here inside the text. So for doing this, I'm going to scroll all the way down. At the very bottom of the blog, you will notice there are a couple of links, and the very tiny last one on the right side here is edit. This will allow you to modify the text in a couple of ways. It's very important and it's pretty tiny and hidden here. So let's click on it. And you are opening the blog like a word processing text. I will just want to add, every single time when you change something in your blog, you need to save it. So for saving this, there are several buttons which look completely different, and I will just show you where the buttons are located for each site, for each menu like this, for each editor. So for this editor, the button is right here, update, on the right upper side. So every single time you add something, you modify the text, you need to click on update. Don't forget that, because you lose your changes. So let's just go try insert a picture here. I will just go and click on add. I will choose media, and you want to pick up a picture from your computer. Let's just say I will click and open a picture from there, and we will show here. And once the picture is uploaded here, I will just select it. In this case, let's just try something. It's already there. Insert inside the text. So this is how you insert. And then don't forget again, click on update to save everything. This is for modifying the text in this way. Now I'm going to go to a completely different menu. So let's just say you want to modify you have normally it'll show by default a couple of links here to social media, which are I removed from my blog, but you will see them. And if you don't like them and or you want to remove a couple of them, I will show you how to do it. Or if you want to change the font on the text, I will show you again how to do that. So for these things, you need to look on the left side here. There's another tiny button. It says customize. Click on it. It will bring us to a completely new page with menus. And on the left side, you have those choices. One of them is site identity. I'd just like to take a second for about this. And normally you will have this case checked. So you will have the site ID, the site name displayed. I don't want that because I already have a name for the blog. But what I want to point out is that the tagline here, these words here are the keywords for a Google search. In other words, when someone is going to search on your blog subject, they will search on Google with a few words. So you need to figure out which words that person will search for your subject. So you need for your site to choose the correct words, a few of them, and to introduce to them, to write them here. You don't have to display them as a title, but you need to have the words here. And this way your site will show up in searches on Google. So don't forget about these words. This is really important. Now you made a change again and you need to save it. There is two options and there's a new button for that. It's right here on the top. What publish means actually is when you click on publish, you will find this on another page. If you click on publish, it means WordPress will send your site as it looks at this very moment on internet. So it's going to bring the site available to internet readers. Maybe you don't want that at this point because your site still needs a couple of changes, a couple of modifications. You'd want to show it already on internet. So if you don't want that, you may go on the small well here and choose save draft. And then click here, save draft. This is like save changes that you already did on the site. Don't forget that every time. So again, you've saved your changes. Let's just keep scrolling through those menus. You have here fonts. And if you click here, it will show a lot of fonts. Probably you can just, I'm curious if this will do. Oh, it will change the fonts for all the site. I don't know how to change the fonts just for a segment of the text. Probably we can figure that out, but that's how you change the fonts. This is the only place I find. Let's just go back. I'm not going to save my changes. Header image, you can choose an image for your area, header area here. Or you just have an option somewhere to remove that image or not display it, which I did for my site. Then you have those menus. And because I did remove those social media links from my blog, you will have something extra menus here with the social media. If you want to remove them or to modify them, just click on those menus, look a little bit through them. You may uncheck cases like this. See how it changed the display, but you also have a delete menu. So if you want to delete some menus, delete some links, you may want to look through to these buttons. I will just show you more buttons like this. Inside those sub menus, you also have remove. So to remove my media links here, I did click or something on something look that was looking like this. I will just let you find which one is it. And that's pretty much about this menu here, page with menus. I will just go back and discard my changes. Like I said, maybe look for the fonts. I didn't really took more time for this, but try to see if you can change the font somewhere here inside the text. I'm not sure if you can do it, but just have a look here and see if you can change the fonts just for one part of the text. For the very last part of this video, I will just show how to remove this gravatar, but I will just, for this reason, I will bring you to a page with tons of new settings, and you may find many new options to modify some items on your blog. So for that, just go here, WP admin at the very bottom, click on it. It's gonna bring up a new tab, and you are perhaps surprised, just as I am, how hidden was all these things and settings for your blog. So you may want to take some time and scroll through these menus and submenus here on the left side, but just for the gravatar thing, I will just click on settings, hover over settings, go to discussion, scroll down, and this is the gravatar that WordPress will give you by default. If you don't want to show it up on the blog, just click here on blank. And as always, like I said, remember to save your changes. And this time, the button to save this, it's not on the left upper corner, not on the right upper corner, it's on the left lower corner. Again, it's different. Save changes. Again, take some time perhaps and see all these menus, what's really changing on your blog. See what you can do with these menus for your blog to modify things. So let's just go back to the site and let's just update the reload the site to see how the gravatar has gone. And you see the gravatar is not there anymore. So again, I show you a couple of menus which are not exactly readily visible or easy to find. It will help you improve your site. Keep in mind, this is that WordPress.com with all these menu displays, they change them all the time. They have updated versions all the time. And the menus may not show at the same place as I'm showing today. I'm at the end of 2017. So keep in mind, there might be changes here. You may not find the same menus if you have a newer version of WordPress later in 2018 or later on. But for now, I hope this helps you and it was useful. Don't hesitate to comment in the comment section of this YouTube video.